Another lesson we learn is that we have different people when it comes to the need of a person has a need, parents have a need, elderly parents have a need, masjid has a need, society has a need. There's some people who look at the fara'id, this is my faradh. So there's no madrasa, okay, I want to come madrasa. Some person thought, well, if there's a flood emergency, without asking, they came, I need to help. Some person phones, shall I come to help? Some person messages, should I come to help? And some person says, gives dua that make Allah make everything easy. Everybody has never done anything wrong out there, really. If messages sent out to Murdisa saying, there's no, don't come Murdisa because there's a flood outside and you can't get in and this thing, and they don't come, there's no farad. No, there's la malama alay. But they have sabikum bil khayrat. They have sabikum bil khayrat. Somebody's come straight. And they said, I'll come, you need help if it's flooded. And we come to help without calling them. So then, automatically, they're striving. In the battle of Tabuk, what happened? Everybody brought what they could. But then you have the elite. Who's the elite? Abu Bakr radiallahu, Umar radiallahu anhu, he comes with half his, that's half of what I got. I left half of my family, I left half here. And Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he says, I left everything is here. So he's, you know, everybody's mind is different. So the more you, society say, well, I have to go to work, I earn for my family, and I've done my farad. You've done your farad. And somebody says, that's not my farad, I need to do more. Community needs me. I have this skill, I do this skill for the community. The masjid, I've got a skill, I'll help the masjid. I've got a skill, I can help the madrasa. I've got a skill, I can help the community in some other way. You have different, when parents get old, you have different types of children. Some children will always go there every day to meet their parents. Whatever happens, every day they go meet their parents. Somebody will phone every day. Somebody phone once a week. Something happens, they go, do you want anything? And someone say, well, mom may probably need this. Dad may probably need this, whether they ask for it or not. So what we have to do is to create this, the jazba and art, whatever you do, the more you put in, the more you get out. So those who came on their own to help out Imranisa, obviously, we would make dua that we're sinful people, but Allah accepts du'as. Others just make dua that, mashallah, this student came to help out so much. And imagine, you do it for your parents. You make dua that, Allah, these people heart up so much, Allah give them barakah and khair. And then Allah will reward you because of your things. After the jazba that you yourself put in the effort, you put in extra, then Allah will open up. If you're so happy that students, somebody actually putting extra effort to look after the madrasa, if you look after the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala extra, imagine how much rahmah of Allah will come upon you, how much barakat and khair will come upon you. Do you understand? So always be sabikun bil khairat. The only thing, don't be this passive, that yeah, to be active, that what can I do more? Look, be active, think out of the box. Think that, how can I help? How can I do more for the community? More for the Muslim, more for my parents, more for my asatiza, more for the Muslims as a whole. Don't just like that, I've done my farad, I pray my five times salah, I pass 5 times Ramadan. That is a farad. But as to become the elite and the noble, you have to look for, what can I do even more? Do you understand? Are you following me? This is very, very important. Those who excel in this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them barakah. Does everybody understand?